आउज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतानिर रजीम बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, होप ऑल ऑफ़ यू आर फाइन। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच, एंड इन पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच टुडे वी विल लर्न ऑल द एट पार्ट्स। बिफोर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दीज एट पार्ट्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट द पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच मीन। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वर्ड्स आर डिवाइडेड इंटू डिफरेंट काइंड्स और क्लासेस which are called parts of speech according to their use or according to the work they done in sentence. The parts of speech are classified in eight in number. First of all is noun, then verb and pronoun, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. In noun we will simply say noun is a word used as the name of a person, place or a thing, animal, feeling and idea. Here is an example: Ashok is a nice boy, Ashok was a great king, and Kolkata is on the river Hooghly. Ashoka is name of a person, so it is noun. Akbar is name of a person, it is also noun, and Kolkata, it is also noun. And in pronoun, pronoun is a word used to replace the noun. Here is a sentence: Preeti is a good dancer, she loves dancing. In this sentence, simply Preeti is noun and she, which reflects this Preeti, or which say which says she. She is the word pronoun, use it instead of noun. Use it instead of noun in this sentence, and Preeti is noun which is replaced by she. And second sentence is the books are where you left them. In this sentence, books is noun and them is used as pronoun. And in third, verb is a word used to express an action or state. For example, I am writing a book. Writing is verb, and second sentence is I am a teacher. In this sentence, am is verb, and fourth one, it is adjective. An adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun. For example, she is a brave girl. In this sentence, brave reflects adjective because it says the quality of this girl. It adds something to the noun, so brave is adjective. In second sentence, he is a tall boy. Tall here reflects adjective because it tells something about this boy. And third sentence, there are 20 boys in the class. And in fifth, adverb. An adverb is a word used to add something to the meaning of a verb, an adjective or another adverb. For example, he finished the work quickly. In this sentence, quickly here reflects adverb. And second sentence, this flower is very beautiful. In this sentence, very is the adverb. And in second part, sixth part, that is preposition. A preposition is a word used with a noun or a pronoun to show how the person or thing denotes by the noun or pronoun stands in relation to something else. For example, there is a bird in the garden. Preposition here in this sentence is in, because it shows position of a noun. Bird is noun, and it in this sentence here in shows that bird is in the garden. And second sentence is the girl is fond of music. So in this sentence, of is the preposition because girl is fond of music, where the girl likes music. And seventh one, that is conjunction. Conjunction is a word used to join words or sentences. In this, for example, 2 and 2 makes 4. And in second sentence, I run fast by missed the train. And eighth one is interjection. Interjection is a word which expresses some sudden feeling. For suppose in we say hurrah and then we put a mark, exclamation mark, we won the game. Hurrah expresses some sudden feeling in the sentence. Woohoo, and then exclamation mark, you are here. Dear students, some modern grammar errors include determiners among the parts of speech. Determiners are the words like a, an, the, these, those, each, every, some, any, etc., which determine or limit the meaning of the of that follow. Hope you have got it. In next video, we will discuss more about grammar. Wish you all the best.